Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the characteristics of series resonant circuit or series RLC circuit. So in the previous video we discussed what is meant by resonance and what are all the characteristics of the resonant circuit, and for the series RLC circuit we derived the total impedance and how the applied voltage and applied current is in phase during the resonant frequency, and we derived the formula for the resonant frequency and so on. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the characteristics of series resonant circuit. Okay, so in the topic under the characteristics of series resonant circuit, so first we are going to see how the impedance, okay, so how the impedance of this series RLC circuit vary with respect to frequency. Okay, then how the current, okay, current flowing through the series RLC circuit, it is varying with respect to frequency. Then we are going to derive the bandwidth of the series RLC circuit, and we are going to derive the half power frequencies, then quality factor and selectivity we are going to discuss. Okay, so in this video we are going to see the two characteristics. One is how impedance varying with respect to frequency, and another one, how the current it will vary with respect to frequency, we are going to see. Okay, so in the next video we are going to discuss the bandwidth with respect to frequency, bandwidth of the series RLC circuit, and selectivity we will discuss. Okay, so it's a very important question, so each and everything is a separate question. Okay, so first one, what about the variation of impedance with the frequency for series RLC circuit? So in order to derive the impedance, first we have to consider the series RLC circuit. So you see, this is the series RLC. Series RLC means the resistor R, inductor L, and capacitor C connected in series with the applied voltage V. Okay, so here the applied voltage is a AC voltage, of the voltage is V, and the frequency is omega. And the corresponding current flowing through this series RLC circuit, you just consider as a I. Okay. And here, this impedance, the impedance of the series RLC circuit, it is not a constant. It will vary with respect to frequency, since here we are using resistance, inductance, and capacitance. So you know the characteristics of inductance and capacitance. The inductance, the reactance of inductance and reactance of capacitance, it will vary with respect to frequency. Okay, so you know, the reactance of inductor is varying directly proportional to the frequency. And the reactance of capacitor is varying, it will inversely proportional to frequency. So that reactance curve already we discussed in the previous video. If you want to watch that video, I will give link in the description box, you can refer it. Okay, so first one, so that's why the total impedance of the series RLC circuit, it will vary with respect to frequency. So that's why now we are going to derive the impedance, and in which situation the impedance of this series RLC reaches maximum value and minimum value, we are going to discuss. Okay, so that's all. So the first one, so here RLC is connected in series, so that's why the total impedance of the series RLC circuit, it is given by Z. Okay, the impedance, it can be represented by Z. So Z is equal to all three component connected in series. Okay, so that's why already you know, if the resistances are connected in series, means the total value is addition of individual component. So that's why the resistor R plus what is the reactance of inductor? The reactance of inductor is already you know J omega L. Okay, and the reactance of capacitor, you know, 1 by J omega C. So this 1 by J, this 1 by J, it can be written as minus J divided by omega C. So that's why the reactance of the capacitor, it can be written as minus J by omega C. So in this thing, if you are taking J outside, so we can write Z is equal to R plus J into omega L minus 1 by omega C. So this is the total impedance of the series RLC circuit. Okay, and here this Z, here you see the Z is not a real part. This Z is a complex quantity. It means it has having some real component as well as the imaginary component. Okay, so that's why we have to find out the magnitude. Okay, so already you know, if one complex number A plus JB is there, means what is the magnitude of this A plus JB? The magnitude is calculated by square root of real part squared plus imaginary part squared. So which one is real part? A. Okay. So the magnitude of this a plus jb is square root of real squared a squared plus imaginary value b squared. Okay. Similarly, you see in this z, this r is a real part a. Okay. Which one is b? The imaginary part is omega l minus 1 by omega c is a imaginary part. So that's why the magnitude modulus of z is equal to square root of the real part r squared plus which one is a imaginary part omega l minus 1 by omega c the whole squared. Okay, so this is said to be the impedance. Okay, magnitude of the series RLC circuit impedance. Okay, so the total impedance we derived, and from this equation we can say that you see this z is depending upon the resistor value, inductor value, capacitor value, as well as omega. What is omega? Frequency. Okay, our given that is the operating frequency, applied frequency is a omega. So if the given signal, the frequency of the input signal is varying, means the z, the impedance of this series RLC circuit, it is also varying. Okay, this z is not a constant. With respect to frequency omega, it will vary. Okay, so that's why we are going to draw the graph for this impedance with respect to frequency. Okay, so the next one, when this impedance, it reaches the maximum value, or minimum value means, so you see, whenever at resonance condition, so you know, if this series RLC circuit is in resonance condition, so under resonance condition, what is the thing? Under resonance, that is in only one frequency omega, that is omega r. Okay, in resonant frequency, the reactance of inductance, the j omega l value and the j by omega c value, both are equal but opposite. In this is a 5, mean this is minus 5. So at the time, the reactance of inductance and the reactance of capacitance gets cancelled. So at the time, the impedance is that is simply the resistive in nature. This is the condition for resonance. Okay, so already we discussed in the previous thing. Okay, so you see, at resonance, the reactance of inductor is equal to the reactance of capacitor. That means XL equal to XC. That is omega naught L is equal to 1 by omega naught C. Okay, so what is XL means? Omega naught L. Okay, where omega naught is the resonant frequency. Similarly, what is 1 by omega naught C? This is the reactance of capacitor at the resonance condition. Okay, so in only that frequency condition, the reactance of inductor is equal to reactance of capacitor. So at the time, this modulus of Z, if you are substituting this condition in that total impedance equation, this modulus of Z is reduced to square root of R squared plus, what is this component? This both value gets equal. So the component is zero. Okay. So modulus of Z is equal to square root of R squared plus zero. So it is a R. Okay. So the impedance at a resonance condition, which is equal to the purely resistive in nature. Okay. This is the condition for resonance. Okay. So already we discussed, you know, at a resonant frequency, the reactance of inductor is equal to the reactance of capacitor. So at the time, the total impedance is purely, at the time, the series RLC circuit, it behaves like a purely resistive in nature. Okay. So that's why the modulus of Z is equal to R. Okay. So then, so we are going to discuss for a different frequency, for if the operating frequency is less than F naught, means how this RLC circuit behave. If the operating frequency is greater than F naught, means how this, impedance of the series RLC circuit. So we are going to discuss. Okay. So under three condition. So the first condition, case one, you see, at F equal to F naught. Okay. So what is F naught? F naught means resonant frequency. At a resonant frequency, the impedance, so you see, at a resonant frequency, the impedance Z is equal to R. Okay. So at a resonant frequency, the impedance of series RLC circuit is equal to the resistance value R. Okay. And this value of impedance, it is minimum. Okay. So only in resonant frequency, the impedance of series RLC circuit reaches minimum value. Okay. Then, so if impedance is minimum, means what is the current flowing through that particular RLC circuit? So already you know, if in one circuit, according to Ohm's law, So the current I is nothing but V divided by R. Okay. If this impedance value is minimum, means what about this current I? The current flowing through the circuit, it reaches the maximum value. Okay. So that's why at a resonance condition, impedance is, since impedance is minimum, the current flowing is maximum. Okay. Maximum in this RLC circuit. Okay. And also, already you know, the current at a resonance will be in phase with the supplied voltage. Okay. Since the reactive component of inductor and capacitor gets cancelled. So that's why current at a resonance will be in phase with the supplied voltage. Okay. So this is the characteristics at F equal to F naught. This is resonant frequency. Okay. Then next one, case two. So what is case two means? At F is less than F naught. Okay. So less than F naught means whenever the given input frequency is lesser than, lower than the resonant frequency, mean how it behaves. Okay. So whenever the frequency lesser than, that is the frequency lower than resonant frequency, the capacitive reactance will be more than inductive reactance. Okay. So you see, what is the total reactance? R plus j omega L minus 1 by j omega C. So whenever the frequency omega, okay, the omega is lower, that is the frequency of omega is a radian frequency, f is a frequency in hertz. Okay, so the omega is nothing but 2 pi f. Okay, so here in second case we are considering the frequency is lesser than f naught. So whenever the input frequency is lesser than resonant frequency, when compared to inductive reactance, this capacitive reactance reaches the maximum value. Okay, since the omega is minimum. Okay, so that's why this total circuit, it will behave like a capacitive in nature. Okay, so at a frequency lower than resonant frequency, the capacitive reactance will be more than inductive reactance. So the total reactance will be capacitive. Okay, and already you know, the capacitive reactance is inversely proportional to frequency. So that's why the total reactance will be capacitive in nature. Okay, so at the time, therefore, the impedance of the series RLC circuit increases when the frequency decreased from the resonant frequency. Okay, so you see this graph. Okay, so you see this is the impedance. Okay, the second graph, you see this is the total impedance versus frequency omega. So whenever the frequency omega equal to omega R, okay, omega R, or sometime this resonant frequency can be written as omega naught. Both are same only. Okay, in some books we are using omega naught, in some books omega R. Both are resonating frequency. So whenever the frequency omega equal to omega R, the impedance value reaches the minimum value R. Okay, so below this resonant frequency, so you see below this resonant frequency, how the impedance, okay, the impedance value decreases. Okay, decreases from some value, some maximum value to this minimum value R. Okay, and after that, above this resonant frequency, how the impedance value increases. Okay, increases. That is a case three. Okay, so you see, so in case two, whenever the frequency lesser than F naught, the impedance value, okay, so increases when the frequency decreases. Okay, this is the thing. And you see the third case. So the third case is whenever the frequency F is greater than F naught. Okay, greater than F naught means this condition. Okay, if the input frequency is greater than resonant frequency, so which one is dominant? So you know the inductive reactance XL is greater than XC. Okay, since the XL is omega L. Already you know, already we discussed the reactance curve of inductance, reactance curve of capacitor separately in the previous video. Okay. The inductive reactance, it increases directly proportional to frequency. But capacitive reactance decreases with respect to frequency. So whenever the frequency is greater than F naught, this inductive reactance increases when compared to the capacitive reactance. Okay, so that's why at a frequency higher than resonant frequency, the inductive reactance will be more than capacitive reactance. Okay, so that's why what is the total reactance? The total reactance will be inductive in nature. Okay, so inductive in nature. That's why when we are increasing the frequency, what about the impedance? Impedance increases. Okay, so therefore, the impedance of series RLC circuit increases when the frequency is increased from the resonant frequency. Okay, so that's why we can get the graph like that. Okay, so you see the this is the variation of impedance versus frequency graph. So in series RLC circuit, impedance is not a constant. Impedance, it will vary with respect to frequency. So this impedance is that is it reaches the value R, minimum value in resonance condition. Okay, so for a lower than resonance frequency, the impedance value you see decreases. Then after resonance condition, the impedance value increases. Okay, so this is the impedance versus the frequency graph. And you see, this is the reactance versus frequency. Okay, so already we discussed in this reactance with respect to frequency in the previous video. So you see, this is the inductive reactance, XL, this is XC. Okay, you know, the inductive reactance is always positive. The capacitive reactance is always negative. This is frequency omega. Okay, so this is the XL curve. Whenever the frequency increases means the inductive reactance linearly increases. Okay, this is the capacitive reactance. The capacitive reactance is negative in nature. Okay, this is the total reactance. Okay, so you see this dark line indicates the total reactance, XL minus XC. Okay, whenever the frequency lesser than the resonant frequency, this series RLC circuit behave like a capacitive reactance. Okay, above resonant frequency, which one is dominant? The inductive reactance becomes dominant. Okay, so because of that, we are getting the impedance curve like that. Okay, so this is the one of the first characteristics of series RLC circuit. Okay, so this is the total impedance. So first you draw a series RLC diagram. So using this diagram, you just write down the total impedance formula. This is the total impedance. Okay, from this total impedance, you just find out the magnitude value. Okay, then at a resonance condition, this total impedance reaches purely resistive in nature R, and this R value is a minimum. Okay, minimum. So in series resonance condition, impedance is minimum. Okay, next we have to derive the three cases. If the input frequency is equal to F naught, mean how it behaves. Whenever the input frequency lesser than resonant frequency, it the capacitive reactance will be dominating. Okay, so that's why whenever we are increasing the frequency, the impedance value decreases. Okay, similarly in third case, whenever the frequency F is greater than F naught, the circuit behaves like a inductive in nature. Okay, so that's why the impedance value increases with respect to frequency. Okay, so you draw this two graph, you just explain. Okay, this is the first characteristics. And next one, we are going to discuss the next characteristics, variation of current with the frequency for a series RLC circuit. So you see, in series RLC circuit, the impedance is not a constant. With respect to frequency, the impedance, it will vary. So automatically, what is the current flowing through the RLC circuit? It is also not a constant. It is also, it will also vary. Okay, so we are going to derive the variation of current with respect to frequency in a series RLC circuit. Okay, so you see, the current flowing through the series RLC circuit is given by the current I is nothing but the total voltage applied divided by the total impedance. Okay, so what is the total voltage applied? E. E, or sometimes you may write V. Okay, so V or E you may use. So the total voltage E divided by the total impedance is Z. Okay, so already we derived the total impedance. What is the total impedance? Square root of the magnitude value R squared plus omega L minus 1 by omega C the whole squared. This is the total impedance. Okay, so this is the total current flowing through the RLC circuit. So you see this formula. So according to this formula, the current I is not a constant. Okay, with respect to frequency, with respect to operating frequency omega, this current value, it will vary. Okay, so that's why the current flowing through this series RLC circuit is not constant. It is also varying with respect to frequency. Okay, so how it will vary, we are going to discuss. Okay, so similar to impedance. So in this case also, we are going to derive it for three conditions. One is at resonance, what is the current flowing? Below resonance, what is the current flowing? Above resonance, what is the current flowing? We are going to discuss. Okay, so the first one, at resonance. Okay, at resonance, already you know, the inductive reactance is equal to capacitive reactance. Okay, so this omega L and 1 by omega C cancelled. So at the time, the Z is simply R. So the current at a resonance, it can be written as E divided by ZR. ZR means impedance at a resonance. What is the impedance at a resonance? It is R. So which is equal to E by R. Okay, so E by R. Since this R is minimum, this Z is minimum, what about E by R? It is maximum. Okay, so at a resonance, impedance value is minimum. So the current flowing through the series RLC circuit is maximum. Okay, so that's why you see the graph. So this is the current graph. This is the current I with respect to frequency omega. At a resonant frequency, you see, at resonant frequency omega R, what about the current I? The current reaches the maximum value, IR. Okay, whenever the frequency omega equal to omega R, the current reaches the maximum value. Okay, below resonant frequency, the current decreases. Above resonant frequency, decreases. Okay, below resonant frequency, if you are increasing the frequency, current increases and then decreases. Okay, so this is the thing. This current is because of this equation. Okay, so because this reactance, this impedance Z is varying with respect to frequency, so that's why the current is also varying. Okay, so similarly, you see the second case. Since the impedance increases for the frequency lesser or higher than resonant value, so the current is also decreases when the frequency is increased or decreased from the resonant value. Okay, so you see, whenever the frequency is decreased from the resonant value or increased from the resonant value, the current, it will decreases. Okay, it decreases. So Y means because of this impedance value. Okay, so you see below resonant frequency, how the impedance is decreases, then increases. So that's why here the current increases, then decreases. Okay, so this current graph is just opposite to that of this impedance graph. So this is the variation of current with respect to frequency in a series RLC circuit. This is the second characteristics. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel. And in the remaining characteristics, that is in the next video, we are going to derive the bandwidth. Okay, so this bandwidth, and we are going to derive the half power frequency of the series RLC circuit. It's a very important big question. Okay, this is also the one of the characteristics. Then next, we are going to derive quality factor and selectivity for this series RLC circuit. So we will discuss that topic in the next video. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel. And please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn the remaining topics in a circuit analysis, okay, circuit analysis in my channel, in the name of circuit analysis, one playlist is there. So in that, all videos are available in order from Ohm's law, KVL, KCL, then problems, mesh analysis, nodal analysis, then all network theorem like Thevenin's, Norton, superposition, current division, all theorem. And related problems all solved in that playlist. That all videos are available in my channel in the name of a circuit analysis playlist. Okay, if you want to if you want to learn the 2 mark problem related to all topics, so in my channel and one more playlist is there, circuit analysis MCQ. So in that, the 2 mark problems are solved topic wise. Okay, so you just learn using that video. Okay, so I will give link for that playlist in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, so thank you. We will meet in the next video with the continuation of the series RLC.